This program is proudly brought to you by the ABPA, Goldpin, AMF and Bowling Balls Australia.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the final of the 2008 SA Cup. Tonight we have Jason Walsh, our top qualifier, taking on Andrew McArthur in tonight's match.
This is going to be a very tough match. I think Andrew, he's been playing this end of the house really well. Jason has to come in, win it in one match. It's going to be very tough for him.
Let's head down to the lanes. Okay, it's finals time, 2008 SA Cup. Jason Walsh taking on Andrew McArthur in this two-game final.
First major tournament of the season. Both these guys will be looking to get off the mark with a win, start 2008 really fast. Jason was runner-up in the last tournament of the year at the Australian Cup in Canberra. He's looking to break that streak and just come away with a win here this week.
But can Andrew McArthur from the Northern Territory take it away from him, beating yourself, Brenton, in the first stepladder final? Bowling very well.
Bowling extremely well.
Let's see if he can take the title here off Jason Walsh. A little bit of a shaky start, threw it very wide.
A little bit wide and possibly a little bit quick. Might have been a little bit of adrenaline in that one, I think. But he's left the 7-pin here, needs to go back and spare that.
Yeah, very lucky, almost left a big split there. A quarter
nearly,
break.
Nearly did, but he spared that during the semi-final match, as I recall, only too well.
But he should go back down and knock this and start things off with a spare.
Should do,
but didn't do. That was not a good shot. Starting things off with a 9 count there. Now, Jason, you don't want to give this man any sniff at all.
No, not at all. Jason Walsh, probably the preeminent bowler in Australia just at the moment, given that Jason Belmonte is overseas, would be the highest ranked bowler currently in the country. Definitely. Very, very solid player, multi-times FIQ representative, solid at the line. Let's see what he does here.
That was a looked like a good shot, just stuck a 10-pin there, not quite getting the carry on the 10-pin.
Not too bad a shot at all, maybe threw it a hair through the break point. Bit unlucky not to get the messenger, but there with his novelty spare ball.
Mirror image of Andrew's last shot. Let's see if Jason can pick up the spare this time, which he has. That's textbook stuff. Good start from Jason.
Jason's spare shooting over the last couple of years has improved out of sight, and as a result, so is his ranking in this country. That's very tight. That's inside.
Not a good shot. Leaves a 3-pin there, almost left a 10 as well. You can see just 10-pin falling late here. Getting a tap.
Yep, got the break there. Much easier spare, just having to shoot the 2-pin. Lane conditions this week were very, very tough. You couldn't swing it outside your target. You couldn't miss it inside your target. It became a question of creating the correct angle of entry, playing relatively straight angles.
He goes back and knocks a spare down, does Jason. Starts things off with a couple of spares early.
Has an early 10-pin lead. Andrew, those very, very lined up on this pair. We'll see how he goes here.
Shaky start in the first frame. Frame two, we want a lot better than his last one. This looks much better. Right in the pocket, he's carried all 10.
Much better. The ball speed there, a little bit slower. Got the earlier break point. Flush in the pocket, 10 in the pit.
Beautiful carry there.
Any time that a bowler like Andrew can point the ball with all those revs, he's going to carry really well.
Oh, and he's carried two in a row here. After that first blemish in the first, he's bounced back with a double.
And that's brought the bat match back to even.
It has. Jason, a couple of spares. They're looking to get on the board here with his first strike. Of course, Jason finishing top qualifier. He had the bye in this first final.
Oh.
Almost got a messenger. He didn't have an opponent in this first stage. Of course, Brenton and Andrew playing it off to face Jason here in the final. So he's had a couple of games off. Nice and refreshed, but did he cool down maybe? Is he a little bit...
He was off to the side practicing, but it can be difficult when you have that break to get mentally back into the match.
You're exactly right. But he's had that experience. It shouldn't take him long to get lined up. His shots haven't been too bad. He's picked up a few spares. He should get lined up fairly quickly, one would think.
That looks better.
What a shot that was. Just gave a little bit more room, threw a little bit wider, and came back for him. What a shot from Jason. On the board with a strike now.
I think you'll find Jason's carry is going to be best when he can play a relatively straight angle like he did then.
Exactly.
Swings
right.
It a bit too wide. If it hits the pocket, he's going to leave half 10 pins. Andrew's been playing a relatively straight angle. And there's the result. He liked that one a lot.
He's fired up now. That's a turkey for Andrew. And we saw him in the last match against yourself, Brenton. Once he gets going, it is hard to stop this guy.
Don't have to keep reminding me of that.
Sorry. But that's the fact. He is running hot at the moment. That's now four. And Jason, he is trailing.
He's got his speed control back after that first shot, which was a little wide, but it was also a little bit fast. Last four, the speed control has been spot on. That's really important on these tough patterns. That's really wide. That's out of here.
Strange shot there from Jason. Just his last few have been right in the pocket or high, and this one he's just overcompensated, I think, and just thrown that one really, really wide.
It looks like he's just struggling to hit a target at the moment. Looking a little bit tense, a little bit tight.
Now he needed to shoot that one to the left and slide it across, but he's hit the head pin straight on. Interesting using his spare ball, taking that one as well.
Well, on tough patterns like this,
ball change here too, Brenton.
Yes, I noticed that. Yep. Trying something a little bit different, see if that'll do the job for him.
Snap, same shot, similar result, which is not a good one.
Yes, as I said, all week he didn't want to be swinging the ball away from the pocket too much. When he made that ball change, it was a ball that he needed to swing away from the pocket to have any chance. He couldn't play a straight angle. Oh, that's a lovely shot though.
He learned his lesson from the last time he left that, and what a shot that was.
That is textbook. Two schools of thought for taking that one. He went the conventional way, the Brooklyn way. Perfect spare.
Tough either way. This guy's not leaving himself anything to spare. He is looking good. Everything flush in the pocket.
This have a look at this shot. Angle of entry. Bang.
Wow. That's how you want to do it. That was a great shot from Andrew, and he's running away with things early on here. Just he starts things off well. And he's finishing well too. This is looking good.
He is what the pros call in dead stroke. The ball speed control is perfect, the hand position's right, it's just all working for him.
And that's one thing Jason doesn't want to hear, but he's bounced back here with a very nice shot. After those last two frames were disastrous for him with those washouts, he's bounced back nicely.
Needs to make a double here. He is in a huge hole at the moment. 43 pin deficit, he is in a huge hole.
Can he dig himself out of it? No, he can't. That's gone high. He went back to his ball that he started with. Mustn't have liked what with that last frame, with that big washout with the ball change. He's just trying to tough it out.
He's trying to tough it out, but I have a suspicion he needs to be standing a He needs to be standing a bit wider, playing around the five board straight up. He can do that. He's won tournaments doing that, and I'm not sure why he hasn't tried that thus far.
And I think you curse his spare shooting.
Yeah, that's going back to some of the bad old days. Now, but Andrew, at the moment, he's carrying the lot. He's got the ball speed. He's got the angle of entry. He's got the rotation, the revolutions, and it's just working well for him.
I know you don't like me bringing it up, Brenton, but what was going through your mind when he was tearing away against you and just bowling beautiful shots like this? What goes through your mind? As an opponent, your opponent is just absolutely blitzing you. What do you think?
Well, I mean, you're trying not to take notice of it, but you hear the crowd. You hear what the crowd's reaction. You hear Andrew's reaction. And you think to yourself, well, I just hope he stops.
There's not much you can do at the end of the day. Jason, just he needs to find his shot. He needs to find it quick, because this
taking
match is
plenty
slipping.
Of time.
Love the balance of the line.
Oh, he hits the line really nice. Again, just having to swing it away from the pocket a little bit. Watch it, there's the flat 10, the 6 pin just lays in the gutter. It's not, you know, it's not flying around the 10 pin, it's just laying in the gutter. It tells me the angle of entry is wrong. I think he needs to be playing straight up from an outside angle, a little more speed. And just, you know, get the slightly shallower angle of entry, and I think that'll work better for him, especially with the ball that he's using.
You know, these pros, these lanes can be very speed sensitive. If you're just bowling one ball too quick and another one too slow, it's just you're not going to get a consistent shot. But a nice bounce back there from Jason, getting a strike this 10th frame, looking much better. Stay down on that nicely.
Much better shot. He looks at, he's playing a more direct line. He's moved in a little bit, playing more direct. Whatever happened, he needed to play more direct. Whichever part of the lane he decided to play, it had to be more direct, and he's done that now. And if he can, you know, throw a three-bagger here and Andrew has an open, it's not an absolute disaster.
Oh, you're right. You just see that last one. He just pumped himself up a bit, and he's bowling well now. Great 10th frame there from Jason. Tell you what, if he can continue this going, his second game is going to be a good one. 184, not completely out of it.
Oh, just that three-bagger there in the 10th, that's telling Andrew, don't slow down at all, mate, because I can still come at you.
Exactly right. Can he keep going? Can he bag out 11 in a row? Maybe no. 7-pin.
Looked like, again, just that hair quick. For that string of strikes, that 8-bagger, the speed control was really nice. Again, I think he just got a hair fast on that one. Ball broke just a hair behind the head pin. Sent the 4-pin whistling around the 7.
Just a small break here for Jason. Just things maybe turning a little bit for him. A turkey for him in the 10th frame.
Needs to make the spare. Missed this one last time.
He did. Good point.
And, gee whiz.
Not convincing.
And watch it on the replay here. Oh, that's got the grappling hooks out to hang on, that one.
Things looking promising here for Jason. Just that 10th frame, very good. Andrew's stopped his string.
Oh, that's inside.
And his last frame, not a good one. Jason's was outstanding. So a 255 for Andrew, a very nice game. Jason, 184. We're back. Jason trailing after his 184 game. Finished it off very nicely. Can he continue this momentum over into the next one? We'll soon find out.
Very, very deliberate. Taking a lot of time on this one. Knows how important this shot is. Oh!
That ball speed just looked, I don't know if it's a camera angle, looked a little bit slower. Not quite sure, Brenton. Maybe he's just found his line. He just knows what he needs to do. And he's pumped up there, isn't he?
He's pumped up. Not watching what Andrew's doing, and when someone's on the sort of run that Andrew's been on, you don't want to watch what he's doing. Just started off a bit quick again.
His last three strike balls haven't been great. That one just not coming up for him, just skidded on a little bit, maybe a little bit too fast. Maybe his release not quite perfect at the moment.
Yeah, might have over-rotated on here, but it just looked to me like he just threw it a hair through the break point.
This is a
tough
spare,
this one.
Picks
made
up
nicely.
If you shoot that to the right of the pins there, Brent, you'll leave the sleeper.
That's right.
Okay, starting things off for the spare. Can he bounce back? Not looking overly solid at the moment, but this shot looks good, tight, but it carries. A nice shot from Andrew.
Again, just like a little extra ball speed there, a little more direct line to the pocket.
Let's see his body. He's looking
fairly relaxed, isn't he?
He is.
Jason now looking to make the double.
Can he bounce back in the second game? Oh, what a shot. Fist pump there. He's fired up. He knows he must make a move now.
He's fired up, but I don't want to see him with too much adrenaline on these tough patterns. That can be poison.
Starts things off with a double.
That's down early.
Oh, no. After a double, just the one thing, he leaves a big four. That is disaster.
I mean, as far behind as he almost has to go for this, try and bounce something out. Ooh, tried hard.
Well, maybe staring down the barrel there of a turkey and a perfect start, but a split and 50 after three frames. That's
not the start he wanted.
Nah, not when you're 71 pins down. Although, hello, a big split here from Andrew.
I still think his ball speed's got a bit quick this game.
I think it has, definitely.
Because he's just throwing the ball through the break point. Although this is now his fourth game on this pair, he might be just starting to get a little bit of carry down.
Especially playing against you, your left-hander, very similar line as well.
That's right. Could be a little bit of carry down kicking in here. Needs to make an adjustment, possibly.
Knocks the one down. Both players very evenly poised after the third frame. Jason a couple of pins in front. Anybody's game at the moment. Now, and it looks like he slowed that one down.
He did slow it down. Might have slowed it down too fast. Who knows?
That shows how tough this condition is. If you're a couple of Ks too slow or too fast, you're going to get punished one way or the other.
That's right. You're going to try and bounce one out here.
Oh, or slide it across.
They tried hard.
Now, two open frames to Andrew. And Jason, with just that one open in the third.
He's pulled about 13 pins of the lead back, so it's 58 down all up. If he can start throwing a bit of a string here.
Just can't seem to throw it out far enough without it sliding out and washing out. He's just having that trouble finding a happy medium.
It is. And as I say, through the middle part of the lane, there's really no area at all. He's just got to be so accurate.
Oh, what a beautiful spare that was.
But by the same token, you know, watching Jason earlier in the tournament, this end of the house wasn't his favourite end. He scored a lot higher down the match play end of the house, the high end.
Bowled very well down that end, but...
And Andrew made his charge towards the match play this end of the house.
But Jason making a charge of his own here, late in proceedings, but still... Andrew, after a couple of open frames, not throwing the ball overly well at the moment, having trouble with his speed.
That looks a little bit better.
Ooh, beautiful
a bit
fist
better.
Pump. He knows that was an important shot. After two open frames, bounced back very well.
But even that one, that was only a board away from being a bucket or something similar, which would have been difficult to spare. It would have put the pressure on.
This
That's a better shot. That's the one, and he knows it.
Wow. Double here from Andrew, just keeping in touch here with Jason. Jason's going to find it very hard here to catch up.
That's basically, taken the lead back out to almost what it was at the start of the match.
4 or 5 frames left for Jason, must make a charge. But if anyone was going to do it, it would be this man.
Must strike here.
Wow, beautiful shot. What a shot there from Jason. Gets a double there in the sixth frame.
And you notice, not as much adrenaline, not as much emotion. He knows that he's got to get out, throw a quality shot here. Not as much emotion after that first strike. Let's see if he can throw a good one.
Seventh frame, it has to be a good one.
No.
Just that problem where he just throws it that little bit too wide and it just skids and then breaks, but it just breaks all too late.
That's right.
And the two pin just sticking for him. He should go back down and knock this down, but... One must think that seventh frame needed to be struck, and it wasn't. Just the spare after the double.
You really needed to throw a striker to put some pressure on Andrew, who has been a bit shaky in this game. Yeah, it looks like there is a change happening to the left side, and he hasn't quite really figured it out. Still hasn't quite figured it out.
No, that's after a double as well.
That looked like it was either a slight pull inside his target or a slight line change. But he's not looking that confident just for the moment.
I think he could have shut Jason out.
Oh, no.
Wow, that is a bad miss. That is not like Andrew at all.
Jason's seen that, and he's got to be thinking that he is still some kind of a rough chance here.
Well, I tell you what, if this next frame from Andrew is not a good one either...
Ooh, don't like it. Don't like it at all.
That is a horrible block of frames here for Andrew. He's had two opens, two strikes, and by the looks of things, another two opens. Very inconsistent. And that shows how important that last frame was for Jason. If he turkeyed and, you know, Andrew with these two open frames, he'd be right in this.
That's right.
But still has a chance nonetheless. If he can get two in a row here on this next block of frames, he could be right in for a close finish here at the end. Well, that's one.
Kicked the 10 pin out. Knew how important that one was.
Edgy your seat stuff. Moving on into the ninth frame, the foundation frame. If you can get into the ninth frame with a double, pressure's going to be back on Andrew.
And I've got to tell you, there's nothing worse than having a big lead after the first game and watch it being eroded. Another one here, we're down to only a 34-pin break.
Crowd, very intense, important shot. Can he drain it? Oh, he has! Fist bump, crowd going nuts. A very popular play on the circuit. And tell you what, this frame from Andrew, if it's open, it's disaster. Ooh, he's stuck a seven pin, five out.
It must go back and make this spare now, because if he doesn't, this match has tightened right up.
And he has missed this pin early on in the first game.
And even when he spared it later in the first game, he nearly missed it. That's a better spare. That is a much better spare.
Under pressure, but still not out of the woods yet.
Well, the situation as it is now, if Andrew does not make a spare, at least a good spare and a good count in this frame, Jason can bag out and win. What happens here? Oh. That's the match right there. What a great shot under the gun.
He's
seen a huge lead being eroded away by Jason's good bowling and his own mistakes, but that was just a good aggressive shot. Didn't leave anything in the bank on that one.
Pretty much the lockout shot here. Oh, and what a shot. 10 pin falls late. And I think the 2008 SA Cup is going to the man from the Northern Territory, Andrew MacArthur. Has bowled well the whole tournament and looks like he's just done enough here in the last game, I think.
Absolutely, he has.
Leaves a 9-pin wobbling.
It doesn't matter. That's a 171 for 426 series. Jason, if he bags out, shoots 229, it's not going to be enough. That's only going to give him 408.
Wow, just did enough there in the 10th frame. Shaky second half of the game, but just done enough. Just held his nerve, and like you're saying, Brenton, no matter what Jason does here, it's just not quite going to be enough.
By the same token, Jason's got a lot. He's got respect for the game, and he's going to want to try and finish out as good as he can.
Now, just looking back on this second game, Brenton, just that first two frames of Jason a double, and then left a big four. If that was a spare or even a strike, you never know where that game would have gone from there. Just that third frame was a turning point, I think.
It was. Anything could have happened. It just left him too much ground to make up. Although Andrew gave him plenty of opportunities, he just left him that little bit too much ground to make up. And again, the single pin in the seventh frame, where he just threw it a little bit wide, a little bit too much adrenaline. Just those couple of
small factors. Things.
Yeah, a couple of small things. 9 count to finish. For a 206, so it's 426 to 390.
So our champion for the 2008 South Australian Cup, from the Northern Territory, Andrew MacArthur. And we have a nice big check for Andrew. And our champion, Andrew MacArthur, for the 2008 South Australian Cup.
Welcome to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. This is Behind the Lanes. I'm here with Andrew MacArthur, the winner of the 2008 SA Cup. Congratulations, mate.
Thank you very much.
Now, you've previously come second in this event, and yes. You've finally come first. How does that feel?
It's great to be up there in front of the crowd, up on the dice, number one.
Yeah, for
especially
sure.
Especially with Mum down here, because, yeah.
Absolutely, and then beating Jason Walsh, a very tough competitor as well. You just didn't seem to fire today.
Yeah, not in the last block there. Jason's always tough. He's been up there at the top for a long while now.
Yeah. Yeah, and you, in the first game, you had that brilliant start, the front seven, I believe, front seven strikes,
yep.
And just seemed to keep you in front enough for the rest of the match.
Yeah, well, the first game got me through on both matches, so
yeah,
all weekend, my first game's been my worst game, my second one's been my better one, so
that's
I'm glad
right.
I swung around.
That's right, and yeah, a very tough field, Brenton Davey defeating him in your first match there.
Yep, it's my first step out of win against Brenton Davey. He knocked me off a few years ago of the Australian Masters, so it's good to get one back.
That's it. And you were saying before how you're very happy to finally win the SA Cup, a very important tournament to you, because you used to live in South Australia?
Yes, way back in 87, I used to live down here. I was born here.
Yep.
So it's good to sort of come home and win a tournament.
That's right, and living in Northern Territory now, everyone back home, be very happy with that?
Oh, yeah, definitely happy. Yeah, got a nice big check to stick up in the bowl.
That's right, a big novelty one, so that was very cool. Now, what's new? What's coming up in 2008 for you?
Just the normal circuit.
Sure.
I guess next one would be the Australian Open.
That's right.
In March at Easter.
Yep.
And then from there, Darrafura Classic up in Darwin, and then K&K Classic, where I'm defending, because I won it last year.
Awesome. Well, it looks like you're going to have a good year this year. I wish you all the best, mate. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much.
I'm sure we'll see you around.
No worries.
This program was proudly brought to you by the ABPA, Golpin, AMF and Bowling Balls Australia.